All right, I'm going Kellen Winslow. Before any of you idiots get any other ideas, we're going David Akers.
It's really hard. He's not giving out A's this year, it looks like.
I got an A because I got Eagles D.
It might be an A minus, but it's up.
Look at his mind work.
Wow.
Because we heard that's what
B plus and an A minus on theirs.
It's pretty good.
Oh, that's because six of those guys have spent time in
here about this, but
we'll be minus.
Ooh, here with Ryan Robitaille. Just got done with our fantasy football draft. Called 24 Karat Nuts, and we are a subgroup of dorkjocks.com. Anyway, so Ryan, what do you think about your grade that you got so far on Chris?
I'm a little disgusted by it. I know he's wrong, but that's okay.
Now, what was your score again?
Give me B plus.
Now, what's the problem you have with that grade?
He's about one full letter grade off from what I should have scored. Should have been A plus.
So you think you should add an A plus?
Yes.
Well, what do you think makes you deserve an A plus? Who do you have on your team?
All I gotta say is Drew Brees, Forte, Greg Jennings, three good starting position players right there.
All right.
Ryan Grant. I got the number 4 overall kicker in the 12th round. That's a steal, baby.
All right. Well, good luck to you this season. All right, we're here with Ryan Ball here. How do you feel so far? I mean, how do you feel personally about your picks?
Well, I feel the picks are upstanding picks. I'm impressed with what was available at the time.
I mean, do you feel that you have a legitimate shot this year of winning the whole thing?
I've won it before. And I'm going to win it again. I mean, everybody has a legitimate shot. And I definitely have a legitimate shot, like everybody else.
Well, what do you think about Chris Johnson, our grader? He grades us every year. I know in previous years you've had bad grades. And he gave you...
Well,
yeah, he gave you a C+.
An outrage has been... it's outrageous. A crime has been performed. I'm looking for an appeal. He's biased. Simply biased because I picked Jay Cutler. He's a Denver Bronco fan. He didn't like the Jay Cutler move. That's why he gave me such a low score. It's a biased move, and it should just be thrown out. You know what? I'm done with this. I'm just saying I'm going to appeal the move. No more. Thank you. We're going over his draft picks for the Fantasy Football League. And Russ, I'm gonna be honest. I look at it. It's not really the most... stellar of drafts here, but confident that you can this year. I just have to ask, what makes you think you can win it this year?
Well, I mean, I honestly think that's kind of a stupid question, but if you look at it, and you're saying you're not too happy with the picks. I mean, okay, Tom Brady, he's fully recovered. He's going to be back to his 50 TDs per year.
Then, of course, I'm going to have to ask you about Peyton Hillis. Most people haven't really heard of Peyton Hillis. Do you know about him?
Yeah, Peyton Hillis is a beast. Okay, he is the running back, halfback role, fullback role, Denver Broncos.
Again, how much did he play last year? How much did he contribute to the Broncos offense?
He contributed quite a bit actually until he got injured. Now he's back, fully recovered, his second year. He's gonna be a beast. You're gonna see him getting some major points in the fantasy league this year. He's a sleeper.
You seem kind of biased towards Peyton Hillis. Is that because he is a Bronco player?
You know, I don't like your questions anymore, so I think I'm done with this. I feel like you're personally attacking me.
And you have the right to feel that
okay,
way.
Okay, see ya. And
it seems kind of biased towards his picks, but the question has to be asked, is this a strong draft? I'm gonna say no. I'm Ryan Ball. Thank you. I'm Ryan again, and I'm here with Chris, the grader, who gave us the grades for our draft. And first question I have to ask is, Chris, where did you learn to critique these drafts, and really, are you qualified to?
I have many years of experience in the field.
I'm gonna question that. Many years of experience. I think for all your years you've been watching football, you've been only watching Philadelphia Eagles. Really, that's one-sided.
No, that is very accurate with your view there. I am Philadelphia first,
foremost. And we got guys like you that come into the draft. You know, 1 year it's Willie Parker. The next year they go after a Brian Westbrook and try to just take all the Philly guys. You know, this year it was Brent Celek. It's the Philly defense. You know, so I got to be tough on people when I grade them.
Well, and what I'm thinking is you're really biased on your opinions. You're looking for the kind of Philadelphia edge on things. If you have Philadelphia in your draft,
sure,
you give a higher
grade. I think all of our personalities are formed by our backgrounds and the environments we're raised in and the approach we take on life. You know, it's all formed by the people we grew up with. And we have to stick to our basics and where we're from, where we came from. And the Cunningham days will forever be number one in my mind. Cunningham comes first, man. Philly defense, 90s, yeah.
Well, thank you. We're running out of time here, but I want to say to Chris, thank you, and mention that Philadelphia has never won a Super Bowl. But again, thank you for your time.
I'll see you on their wagon next year, too.